4th August, Saint John Mary Vianney, priest, Memoria. Born at Lyons in the year 1786, after overcoming tremendous difficulties, he was finally ordained priest. He was given charge of the parish of Ars in the diocese of Belley, and by his forthright preaching, personal mortification, prayer and charity renewed it and increased it in a wonderful way. His help to those who came to the sacrament of confession was renowned, and people flocked to him from all sides to obtain his advice. He died in the year 1859. A reading from the Catechetical Instructions of Saint John Mary Vianney. The noble task of man, to pray and to love. Consider, children, a Christian's treasure is not on earth, it is in heaven. Well then, our thoughts should turn to where our treasure is. Man has a noble task, that of prayer and love. To pray and to love, that is the happiness of man on earth. Prayer is nothing else than union with God. When the heart is pure and united with God, it is consoled and filled with sweetness. It is dazzled by a marvelous light. In this intimate union, God and the soul are like two pieces of wax molded into one. They cannot anymore be separated. It is a very wonderful thing, this union of God with his insignificant creature, a happiness passing all understanding. We had deserved to be left incapable of praying, but God in his goodness has permitted us to speak to him. Our prayer is an incense that is delightful to God. My children, your hearts are small, but prayer enlarges them and renders them capable of loving God. Prayer is a foretaste of heaven, an overflowing of heaven. It never leaves us without sweetness. It is like honey. It descends into the soul and sweetens everything. In a prayer well made, troubles vanish like snow under the rays of the sun. Prayer makes time seem to pass quickly and so pleasantly that one fails to notice how long it is. When I was parish priest of Bresse, once almost all my colleagues were ill, and as I made long journeys, I used to pray to God. And I assure you, the time did not seem long to me. There are those who lose themselves in prayer, like a fish in water, because they are absorbed in God. There is no division in their hearts. How I love those noble souls! Saint Francis of Assisi and Saint Colette saw our Lord and spoke to him as we speak to one another. As for ourselves, how often do we come to church without thinking what we are going to do or for what we are going to ask? And yet, when we go to call upon someone, we have no difficulty in remembering why it was we came. Some appear as if they were about to say to God, "I'm just going to say a couple of words so I can get away quickly." I often think that when we come to adore our Lord, we should get all we ask if we asked for it with a lively faith and a pure heart.